Let's take a moment here and make friends with OpenVMS. In this section, we'll review some basic commands and utilities of the digital command language, or the command line, of the VMS operating system. VMS is the operating system that your Pynet software runs on. VMS and Pynet continue to be a growing part of OSI's business, but only for the data collection or interface nodes. Approximately 1,300, almost 1,400 Pi3 systems have a Pynet. Many have more than one Pynet as of the time of this course. So we're talking mid-2003. So let's get started. I've opened the terminal window, and I'll log into our system. My username is OSI, and my system manager has given me my passwords. And if I type it right, I'll get in. There we go. Usual prompt is a dollar sign. Your prompt may be something else. One of the things to learn about VMS is that help helps. There's an extensive set of documentation and information online, almost the whole documentation set for VMS. So this help system supplements, or rather is supplemented by, about 15 feet of bookshelf documentation, but most of it's right here. It's possible to learn many things about VMS and work your way through many problems just by looking at help here. For example, the directory command, almost all of us understand what that is. The directory command in VMS is quite extensive. I can type help and dir and get pages and pages of information about the directory command. I see a couple of interesting things here in the listing. There's date and there's size. Whoops, didn't want to do that. So let's see what happens if I use those in combination. If I do directory slash date, I get a list of the files in my directory, and that's quite a bit different than what I get if I just type dir. If I type dir slash size, then I can see that I get some number here. It tells me the size of the file. Turns out this is in blocks. And I can combine these together. So by using these, By using these qualifiers, the slash somethings are called qualifiers, that allows me to modify the command and use the various functions together in combination. So date is a qualifier, size is a qualifier, and items that are separated by a colon or an equal sign are called parameters. So qualifiers take parameters. So this gives you a little bit of an intro to the command line here. Also, let me take a look at the directory or file path information. The syntax here, DKA300, separated by a colon, is the name of the disk. The name of the disk might be a device or some shortcut that's been defined for your system. Enclosed within square brackets will be the directory path. Directories can be many layers deep. In this case, I'm looking at a directory called PySource that's at the root of the DKA300 disk. File names. File names have a name, an extension. We're probably familiar with that from even our Windows experience. And then there's this funny thing on the end, the semicolon and a number. The semicolon and a number is the version of the file. And this DECW junk file is interesting. There's two of those in my directory. VMS keeps multiple versions of a file. This is our way of having a capability to undo or go back to earlier versions of a file. So junk 2 is the most recent version of the file, and DECW junk 1 is the previous version. Depending on your system manager, there may be settings on the system that block you from having very many versions of a file. The system may keep you to one or two or three versions of a file, or may let you keep many. One of the things that you may want to be aware of is that VMS does keep multiple versions of a file, as we see here with these two. And you'll want to go through and do some housekeeping from time to time. And the command to do that is purge. Most VMS commands allow you to log the output, and that will confirm to the screen what's being done. So in this case, you can see what happened. Logging is optional, normally it's disabled. In the next session, we'll continue with making friends with some of the more common commands you're going to need to know as part of your activities as a system manager or someone who's supporting the data collection on a PyNet node. In the last video, I mentioned some terms I should probably back up and define for you. In the VMS system, these commands that we can type in at the prompt are interpreted by an interpreter that's called DCL. I referred to that earlier as a digital command language. I also mentioned that in VMS we have file names that have a name, an extension, a period separates those two parts of the file name, and a file version. VMS is probably one of the original long file name operating systems in that you can have file names and extensions that are very long. 32 characters for each is not unusual or impossible to have here. With some files you may see something like this where there's a special character in the name, such as dollar sign or underscores. These special characters really are just characters like any other characters. However, some applications use these to indicate the system files or other things. So don't be put off or confused by these. In this particular example, I took a look at the directory of all the files that are star.sys in something called sys$system. sys$system is one of several special directories where the operating system keeps its files. sys$system happens to be where most of the programs that make up the operating system live. When I see the directory output here, I can see that I got two directories listed. This is a special type of directory that has a search path, so the directory points to more than one place. This is not very common, but with the operating system there are many directories that are cross-linked, so I wanted to show you that. Some more information about what we see here in our directory output. When you do a normal directory, you get a trailer that tells you how many files, and if you have a directory command that lists more than one directory, you also see how many directories you listed. Another thing that comes with a directory output will be a header. The header tells you the directory that the files you're looking at come from. It's possible to get a directory command without these. Another feature of the directory command I used earlier, and what you can see me doing here is using my up and down arrows to page through the recent commands I used. So VMS has a command history that you can take advantage of. When I type dir slash date slash size colon all, the colon all caused the system to show me two different size parameters for the file. The first is the number of blocks that have been actually written to. The second is the number of blocks that are allocated. So you can see that the allocation size of a file may be different than what we've actually written to. A security feature of VMS is that you normally can't read information from a file that you have not written to. So even though this file occupies 9 blocks on the disk, the system's only going to let me see one of them. Another term I should define while I have this up in front of us here is blocks. Blocks are the unit of size for files and objects in the file system. Block is equal to 512 bytes. So another way of saying that is that a 1-block file is approximately 500 bytes. A 3-block file is approximately 1500 bytes, or we might say 1.5K. One of the things you can do with a directory command is filter the output. So I might look at all the files that are star.com. I might look at all the files that are star.txt. Okay, so this allows you a very powerful way of looking at the directory information. Another thing you may have noticed is that I'm abbreviating some of the commands. If I do help dir, we see that the name of the directory command is this thing, all spelled out, all one word. However, I've been typing dir. Why does that work? VMS commands can be abbreviated, and in many cases you can abbreviate them to the fewest number of characters that are unique. So DIR is just enough characters to uniquely identify the directory command. In VMS, commands are guaranteed to be unique at 4 characters. So DIRE must be unique and cannot be duplicate with any other command in the system. So if you're defining commands or defining shortcut cuts to commands, you want to keep this in mind. Shortcuts to commands are powerful things, however, you want to use them sparingly, especially in stored procedures that you may write. The problem with shortcuts is that they may be ambiguous, and also they may conflict with other commands and other utilities that are on the system, so spelling things out is always a good practice. In the next section, we'll continue with learning VMS commands and utilities.